Now let's try to make our own thermodynamic compound database. So, for example, if you find the new compound information, and you can create your own compound database. So for that, you have to click the compound module here. Then you're going to open this kind of the compound, the compound module. So the very first thing you have to do is you have to make your own database first. So what we can do is you can go to the file here and then say new database. So I'll click new database. Then it'll ask you, okay, where you want to store your new database. So for example, let me go to the my C hexade directory, and then I'll say this is INHO database, for example. So then the compound database, the extension is automatically CDB file. So, and then you can save it. Then here you can see that your new database is formed, and this is read and writable database, so you can change the actual data. So how you create your new then compound data. So the very first thing you have to do is you have to say what kind of the element data you want to actually create. So for example, let's say I have aluminum. Okay, I want to make aluminum data. So and then so you name it, and then you have to say that, and then if you go to the edit menu, you can say that add aluminum into the INHO database. So let's go back again. So very first thing is you have to click the your database you want to enter this new element, new information. So this is INHO database, and then you write your species name here, and then go edit. Then it automatically recognizes, okay, you want to put the aluminum into the INHO database. Okay, so then if you click, then it'll ask you, okay, what kind of standard actually the information, what kind of the energy unit and the pressure unit you want to use. Typically joules and 1 bar or 1 atm is okay. And then say yes, okay. Then as you can see here, the aluminum new data, blank database for the aluminum species is formed here. And of course, I mean the molar weight is coming directly from the periodic table information, so it's there. And then you have to now start to add information. So compound name. So this is for you. So I can say that aluminium, for example. And then now you have to add your heat capacity and H and S298. So how we can do it is you go to this aluminium and then click this one, and then to the mouse right click, then it is going to give you the additional information like this. So in the hexade, typically when you click the left button, it means I'm executing the something, some menu, and then when you do the right click, it will give you the additional information. So in this case, you go here to the mouse right click, then it will give you the additional possibility. So add a phase, and you have to decide which phase, what's the state of this aluminum phase. So I will say solid state, then I can click solid. And then as you can see here, you have H, S, and then phase name. So you have to now enter all this information, and then also heat capacity as well. So if you have information about this, for example, let's assume H is 0, S is 25 joule per mole Kelvin, and then heat capacity is like, for example, 20, and then this is 0.05 with the temperature, and this is 0.001 with the temperature, T square, and etc. So you have to enter all the information. And then once you finished all the entering all the information, you can now save it. And this extended menu, you don't have to always fill it up, but at least you have to fill up H, S, 298, and the heat capacity to generate new data. Or if you have the actual information in terms of the Gibbs energy equation itself, then you can go here, Gibbs energy, and edit. You can just enter one by one. Then if you say okay, it will automatically converting back for you to the H, S, and the CP function too. So both of them is possible. Okay, so once you finish it, then you have to save the information. So far, it is still unsaved actually the information. So when you see that this kind of the colorful molecular shape here, it means something is unsaved. So you have to go here and then click save button here, then it will save actually your information. So this data is ready for you to use in the other application in FactSage. Okay, so we're going to put up this one later. And so this is the one of the way you can create a new database. And if you have all the some of the information by yourself, then you can make this way. And of course, you can add more phase, for example, liquid, gas, and etc. Okay. The other actually the way we can actually create the new data is you can simply, for example, modifying the current available data in the factory. So let's assume I have calcium. Okay. So and then if you click the calcium, then you see there's the many different database containing calcium. And then let's for example look at this one. And here I have calcium. Okay, so let me try again. Remove the clear the list of the compound. Okay, then there's nothing. And then let's say calcium. Click, then you can have packed database containing calcium. And then here, okay, S1. Okay, it's good, but I feel like there's some information is wrong. Then you can modify some of this information and save it into the your new database, your private database. So how we can do it is you can just click S1 and then push the mouse left button and then drag it. And then you have to push the left button continuously, and then you can drag it to the your database. So in the database. Sorry. Let me try again. So calcium, and then click, and then go to your inner database, and then drop it. Okay. If you release the, your mouse left button, then it will drop in the database. Let's try again. So you have to take the calcium. You cannot take only S1, and then go. You have to take the entire information, calcium, and then push the mouse left button, and then drag it. Continuously with the mouse button is clicked, and then you go in a base and then leave it. Then it will go into the, it will copy the your calcium information from the PACTPS to the inner database. Okay. Now, in your private database, because this is write and read and writable, so you can actually modify the information here. So, for example, if you click here now, this information you can change it. So for example, if I don't like S2, S3, and S4, then I can simply go there to the mouse right click and delete the phase. And then you go to the mouse right click and delete the phase. Mouse right click and delete the phase. So you can get only solid S1. And because there was some change, so that's why the color is changed again as the blue and red here. And if you save it, then your calcium is your calcium information is saved with only S1 information here. And then, for example, if you find out that this H and S is not accurate enough, then you can modify this one, for example. So let's just take this one. Instead of 41.5, let's say 45 joule per mole Kelvin. And then, because something has been changed, so you have to always save, then this new database can be actually the is prepared simply by copying the information from the your existing database and into the your private database, and by the and then you do the very small modification. So this is also another way to create a new database. Okay. And the other actually the way to create a database is combining two existing information and then make the new one. So for example, let's look at this information here. So let's assume I found new compound called the CASI, and somebody in the literature, for example, and then provide this information. So calcium solid and silicon solid reacting together and produce the calcium silicon solid phase. And this calcium silicon and this Gibbs energy of reaction is this value. So and Gibbs energy of reaction is H of reaction minus T delta S of reaction. So delta H in this case is this value. Delta S is minus of this value. So it's minus 5 joule per mole Kelvin. So let's assume I have this information and I want to use this information to create the new database. Then what we can do? So just come back here and then I want to use the this information, tools and then mixer. So we want to make calcium silicon 1-1 compound by mixing existing calcium and silicon. So for example, let's take this one. So let's say I want to take a calcium S1. Okay. And then click, push, then you'll copy actually the calcium. And then I go here and I enter the another information, silicon. So let's assume this silicon is okay, S1. I take this one. Then I have calcium silicon product is ready. If you want to have the two calcium or two silicon, for example, then if you click one more, then it will increase and then decrease. And you can see here, okay? And then you can select, of course, the state of the actually page, solid liquid gas page, and etc. And then now what you have to do is you have to copy this CASI information in your private database. So I'm clicking in home base. And then this actually the paste menu is activated now. And if you push this one, then CASI, just combination of CA and SI without any modification, is copied back here. So if you click this one now, and let's now close it. If you click this one, you can see that, okay, this CASI H29 is 0 and S298 is 60.4. So this value here is basically combination of this value and this value. Okay, just sum of these two is just enter in here. So all the CPN, everything is just sum of the calcium information and silicon information. So that means so far we create this one by using this equation, we make a CASI, but delta G of reaction equal to 0. That's what we did. Now we want to enter this information inside of this new database. So minus 10,000 for the H. So we have to make H become minus 10,000. And S, we have to change the current S value by minus 5 joule per mole Kelvin. So the most easiest one is go back here. So we say that this is, so current value is 0. So we add up minus 10,000. So minus 10,000 in this case. Okay, and you have to always check your unit, so it's in joule, so minus 10,000 is entered. And now S, so it's just the current value is 60.4, and we have the minus 5 joule per mole Kelvin of the S, it should be corrected here, so it means it should be 55. Okay, so very simple. So in this way, you can create your new data, CASR. And then, of course, you can utilize this kind of database later in your thermodynamic calculation. Okay. And also, if you want to check, okay, how does this Gibbs energy or enthalpy and entropy, Cp, is actually changing with the temperature, then you can click CASI, for example, S1, okay, and then view data. Then it can open the view data menu and show you the information of what you actually enter here. So INO database and CASI, heat capacity is this function, HS. And then you can also go to the table if you like, most table. Then you can see that this is the Gibbs energy change with the temperature, Cp, H, Gibbs energy, and S change. The change of the S for the your new CASI compound. You can let you click. And also you can make, of course, graph. Okay, so you can do all this one as you did in the view data before. So now close it. So this is the way you can generate your new thermodynamic database, okay, especially compound database. And so this database can be used later for your thermodynamic calculation.